Ali returns with a tray on which are four cups of coffee, along with cream instead of milk and sweetener instead of sugar. The coffee is so bitter and stewed that it hits me like a punch in the face. Ali is breathing heavily as he joins us at the table.
"We've just been to see Yulchen," says Clutcher, "and she reckoned we should pop in here because you might be able to help us."
"Yulchen,
says Ali, leaning back and drinking coffee. "If we want anything, we'll have to ask. Is Heine Madsen here by any chance?" I ask.
"Ha!"
says Ali, and Bruckner jumps a little. "Is he?" I ask.
"What do you want with him?" asks Ali.
"Just a chat," says Bruckner.
Ali looks at Klatscher.
"They just want a chat," says Klatscher. "Honest.
Anyone going to find out about this?"
asks Ali. "No," I say, "we weren't here."
"The boy's under my protection, and he's done nothing wrong. He's such small fry that nobody even sees him. If any harm comes to him after he's spoken to you, you'll never set foot in here again."
"Well, that's clear." "Nothing will happen to him," I say. "You have my word."
"Okay,"
says Ali, standing up. He goes to the bar. Behind the bar, there's a door. Ali pulls a key from his trouser pocket and unlocks the door.
"Come here a moment."
Heine Madsen is about Klatscher's age and has a round head. His small bull neck is perfectly shaved. His eyes flit to and fro, and he looks like he's borrowed his front teeth from a rabbit. He's wearing a thick sweatshirt, baggy joggers, and bright trainers. When he sees us, he takes a step back and looks at Ali in desperation.
"Who's this?"